Hello everyone, Phoenixville here, and welcome back to another Farming Simulator 15 Let's Play, Let's Talk, where we play Farming Simulator and we talk about a topic to keep myself entertained. I hope this doesn't kill the grass. Doesn't seem like it. Good, very good. This is withered. This field starts off withered, so you have to get rid of it. But anyway, today's topic is going to be about smoking. I don't own this field. How do I own this field? Let's hop in the pickup and go to the office. But anyway, I know it's probably going to upset some of my smoking friends and subscribers, but you know, somebody asked me to do it, and I could make a very good video on it because, let's face it, I've never smoked a day in my life. But I grew up in a household where I had two brothers that were heavy smokers. My dad was a heavy smoker. My mom at one point in her life was a heavy smoker. My sister was a heavy smoker at one point in time when she did live at home with my parents. My brother-in-law, heavy smoker, was around him a lot. Aunts, uncles, like... It was a very, very smoking family, and you're gonna like think to yourself, you know, how did you never smoke a cigarette? We'll get into that in the video, but I can make a very good video on that from a person who's dealt with it, been around it so much so throughout his lifetime. So I figured I would, and let's start by I've never smoked a cigarette in my life, never even tried a cigarette, like never. Took a puff off a cigarette or anything. It's just not appealing to me. It just never was. The smell is horrible. You know, when someone's smoking around you and you get that taste in your mouth, it tastes horrible to me. Just never found it appealing whatsoever. And even when I had the chance to try it, it wasn't something I wanted to do. So it was easy for me to say, you know, no. And even the peer pressure, I'm like, yeah, no. Okay. Anyway, with that being said, I don't look down on people that do smoke. It's not like it's,
yeah, we can't be friends if you smoke a cigarette.
You know, that's not the case. Matter of fact, a lot of the Outcast posse are smokers. Luckily I don't have to be around them. So, you know, that's one shining thing. That you can take apart from our friendships is I don't have to be around that. And those that don't smoke, and there's a couple that dip. I've never done that. I've never done any tobacco, to be honest with you. Never smoked a pipe. Never you know, dipped. Never any of that. Never had the want or desire for it. It was field number 35. Where's 35? 37, 36, 35. And then what's the field next across from 17? We're going to go ahead and plow that under 2 because it's clover. I don't know what I have that will do clover. So purchase this field. Yes. All right. Do we own the fields around? Yes. We own 18, which is... Wait, do we own 20? So 22, we need to buy 22 as well. 22. Sorry, I'm off topic here. But I'm... Okay. So 20, 22. Let's buy 19 as well. 19, hey, yeah, you. I want you. Might as well buy 2134 too. Just coat that area. That'll be our main setup. 34 and 33. Sound good? Yeah, 34 and 33. There we go. 34, 33. Okay. Or vice versa. Anyway, that's it for now. Thank you guys so much for taking all my money. It means a lot. I'm gonna hop back in the pickup. But what was I saying? I never had the desire to. Like, all my friends loved it when the races came to town, when NASCAR came up to Dover, because they would just have me chill out with them and go around and get all the, you know, the free samples. They always give out a can of dip around all the places. They'd always take me because I'd get the free samples as well, but I wouldn't use them, so then they could bum them off me. But oh, okay, I gotcha. I never had the one desire to. Why, you ask? It just, when you live with a bunch of smokers, you, no matter where you go, like after I moved out, a lot of my clothes for, I'm talking months after I moved out, dude, nice turn signal. Even months after I moved out, I could still smell the smoke on me. My hair, it just, when I washed it, it felt all, you know, just icky. And stuff like that. You know, when you grow up in a household that smokes so much, you know, white walls turn yellow, your nails turn yellow, you know, your clothes, you go to school smelling like smoke all the time. It's just so unappealing to someone who grew up in it. It's just, not my thing. So, you know, whenever I was offered to smoke a cigarette, I would always turn it down. Just, yeah. I'm so glad I did, because, you know, you look at the prices of cigarettes are just going up. Here soon you're going to go to pick up a carton of cigarettes and be like, yeah, give me those. And the cashier's going to pull out a hatchet and be like, which arm? Because it's going to cost an arm and a leg. I don't know. Do I think that people should stop? Yes. I really do think smoking is probably one of the most, you know, terrible things you can put into your body. You know, it's not just even, it's just tobacco. All the chemicals that come with it. Just, I don't see what's so appealing about putting that into your body. Ugh. I had a grandfather that he smoked a lot. Matter of fact, he was in, I barely remember him because he passed away when I was really young. I think I was 8 when he passed away. But I do remember going to family get-togethers, and this guy was on an oxygen tank. Years of smoking had made it so he couldn't even breathe on his own. He couldn't even breathe normal oxygen or oxygen in the air like the rest of us. He had to have pure oxygen because his lungs were just so gone, okay? And he was sitting there with an oxygen tank smoking. He'd take a breath in off the tank and then take a hit off the cigarette. That's how dedicated to his tobacco he was. And when he passed away, they said his lungs were so black. They've never seen a worse condition. Like, his lungs were like, you know, you could step on it in the middle of the road at night and never know. You know, once you got home and you saw that there was like blood. Anyway, that all come from years and years and years and years of smoking. Now, I know it's hard to quit. I know it's a hard thing. I've seen my dad struggle with it pretty much my whole entire, I want to say teenager into adult life. He's been smoking since the age 14. And he's tried numerous ways to quit smoking, and it just never helps. This guy's had 2 heart attacks. He's got 2 stents in right now. And when each time he went to the hospital, even though the smoking was one of the causes for his heart attacks, he couldn't wait to get out of that hospital bed to go outside and smoke a cigarette. It's hard, and I'll never look down upon somebody for not failing to to give up smoking because I know I someone I love so dearly, I see him struggle with it every time he attempts to. Luckily, he's got it way under control, and he no longer buys cigarettes. He actually buys the tobacco, and his girlfriend makes their cigarettes for him. She rolls them and everything, which is a little bit better than buying them from the store because, you know, again, you don't have all that crap built into it, if that makes sense. But I do, I see the improvement in him. He goes from, he used to smoke like over a pack a day, and then he gradually down. He only smokes a couple every day. You know, when he's really stressed, he'll smoke a little bit more, but you know, he's really got cut down, and I couldn't be prouder of him. The only way I could be proud of him is he finally found a way to quit it, which I don't see him doing it. Again, he's been smoking for, what, 40-some years now? It's just something that it's once you're hooked onto it, you know, it's something that you'll never get rid of. It's a drug. That's what it is. Tobacco is a drug, and if anyone claims otherwise, I'll throw it in your face. It's a drug, just like marijuana is a drug. The only thing is, tobacco doesn't give you any mind-altering effects, if that makes sense. Tobacco just gives it's a craving that you get. You got to have that nicotine in your system, and if your body doesn't have it, you go through withdrawals and all this crap. So it's very much a drug. It's something foreign you're putting in your body, which is not good for you. So I challenge you that if you're smoking, and if your smoking is causing you problems, such as health problems, if it's causing you money problems, say you have to choose between one thing or another because you gotta go get a carton of cigarettes, I challenge you to cut back. You know, smoke a cigarette less a day, then, you know, next month smoke two less a day. And if you get yourself down to the point where you're ready to quit, then do it. That's my challenge for any smokers. And if you've never smoked a cigarette in your life, I challenge you to never try it. Because once, like I said, once you're, you know, it gets its claws into you, it just never relents, never lets go. But I know it's hard. I really do. I know it's hard. You don't have to, you know, tell me otherwise. Again, my dad, I've watched the guy struggle numerous times throughout my lifetime trying to quit, and he could just never do it. I'm just proud of him that he's got it down to where he only smokes a couple cigarettes a day compared to, you know, over a pack a day. So that's really all the improvement one can ask for. I don't know what else to touch on it. I can make a good video about it. It's just a really short video. I'm going to finish plowing this field or cultivating it, what have you. Let's talk about drugs. Nice segue, right? Again, drugs is something I've never tried. Never had the desire to. I've had numerous opportunities to try, you know, different substances, and it's just something I don't want. I never, you know, a lot of people can't go through life saying they've never tried drugs. But unless you consider alcohol a drug, which it sorta is, and actually I think at one time it was classified, if it's not still a drug, but alcohol is my downfall. But drugs, I'm talking about like marijuana and, you know, stuff. numerous times going throughout high school, I hung out with some of them kids. I did. I was a kid that, you know, I didn't restrict myself to one, you know, group, if that makes sense. Like, I hung out with the jocks, I hung out with the goth kids, I hung out with the stoners, I hung out with the redneck crowd, I hung out with the misfits, and all. You know, I hung out with all of them. And that's one thing I do pride myself on. I never disliked someone because of who they were. You know, I saw someone and I wanted a chance to learn. You guys see that now. I don't discriminate on what you are. I discriminate on your personality. If your personality sucks, I want nothing to do with you. But in all walks of life, there are amazing people out there. That's one thing you'll go through in life learning. Yes, there are some Nimrods that, you know, like to give certain stereotypes a bad rep, but in all walks of life, any type of stereotype you look at, there are amazing people out there. And that's another reason why I can never call myself racist, because I find good in anyone, any group. Now, there are some people out there that are just terrible human beings, and you need to stay away from them, but never look down on somebody because of who they are. Like, especially this is for, like, the younger kids, or, well, not the younger kids, the younger adults, the ones that are still in high school. Never look down on someone because, you know, they're goth. I don't even know if goth is still a thing. I think that was just a phase back when I was in high school. But never look down on somebody because they're goth. Never look down upon somebody because, you know, they're a jock or they're a nerd or what have you. Because you'll find amazing people. And later on in life, could become good friends of yours. I was lucky enough that I never had to be associated with one group, if that makes sense. You know, like, you know, jocks and nerds are supposed to hate each other or whatever. And in many ways, that was the case. They were polar opposites of each other. But I hung out with them. This just went from drugs to freaking groups in high school. Anyway, discrimination or whatever. But, you know, I did hang out with the stoner kids. Matter of fact, some of my good friends were in high school were stoners. You know, I had a couple of them in my shop class, which I spent pretty much half my day every single day with. They were good people. Like, you know, they even today they're active in the community and stuff like that. So maybe not your typical stoners, but no, seriously, they were good people that enjoyed being around. But every time they would go off to do their thing, I never went with them. Like, a lot of times they used to get high out in the parking lot behind the school, and, you know, I was invited numerous times, but when the joints and the lighters came out, Phoenix went about his own business. A lot of times, I even witnessed drug deals inside school, from kid to kid. They were selling drugs off, and while I never said anything because that was their business and they're gonna regret it later on in life, I never wanted to partake in it. When I seen it happening, I walked away. It wasn't my business. I didn't want any part of it. I didn't even want to be a witness, so that way when someone got called in, you know, got caught with it, nobody can be like, hey, well, Phoenix was there. You know, so it was just that sort of deal. Again, it was just, I had two brothers that I grew up with that lived at home all my life. Literally, when I moved out, they were still living at home, that were potheads. And actually, the oldest of the two was more than just a pothead. He was pretty much anything head. You know, if it made him feel good, he was taking it. And I seen how dumb it made them. I seen how careless they were with it. And I guess that's what turned me off. I was like, I don't want to be dumb. right. So it was just something I never wanted. Alcohol was my downfall. Alcohol, you know, I grew up, we went camping, the adults sat around the campfire with their beers and everything. And when I was a teenager, I got into my brother's, you know, alcohol stash, and that was the beginning of the downfall. Now, I got really bad in my teenage years with alcohol, to the point where one night I was dumb enough to get so drunk that I actually called my mom to ask her if it was okay that my friend drove the truck home, because I was too... I said, something's wrong with me. And she's like, what's wrong with you? I was like, I don't know, I just got a headache, and, you know, I can't really feel my legs. And of course, she went into panic mode, and I was like, yeah, I'm fine. She's like, have you had anything to drink? I was like, no. Okay, a little bit. Alright, a lot. I don't know exactly how much I had to drink that night. I know I downed a pint of peppermint schnapps, which I regret it for the next 2 days, because it's all I could freaking taste. And now, even to this day, when I taste the freaking candy cane, I kind of throw up in my mouth a little bit. I was drinking brandy right from the bottle. I was drinking Captain Morgan right from the bottle. Jack Daniels right from the bottle. You know, anything I got my hands on that night, I was drinking. And it got that way pretty much... every night I got to hang out with my friends. Alcohol was easy accessible because we had some friends that were over the age that could get us whatever we wanted. So I went through a very, very, very dark time. You know, my parents were splitting up. I was alone. I couldn't keep down a stable relationship, and I wasn't understanding why. So I drank to forget all that. I drank it. You know, here I am. I'm 16, 17, thinking that my life was going to be ending because I couldn't keep a girlfriend. You know, I had a girlfriend every couple weeks because I don't know. I still don't understand these to this day why I decided to date some of the girls I did. Maybe it's because I was drunk. That's the best I can come up with. But... you know, it was a way to numb the pain, for me to forget the real issues I was dealing with. I really hated myself and so on and so forth. But it came to a point where I hated myself more for drinking, and I realized that crowd I was hanging out was really enabling my stupidity, and I stopped hanging out with them. I had come to the point one night, one held this giant knife to my throat because apparently something was said about a girl that, oh, one of my ex-girlfriends decided she was going to send him some pictures after we split, and I was rather upset about it. And, yeah, he held a knife to my throat, and that's the day I stopped hanging out with him. I know that's a crappy story, but that's what it is. Alcohol can make you do some dumb, dumb stuff. So, yeah, alcohol is my downfall, but never, never tobacco or drugs, which I'm proud of. And I'm proud to say that While I still drink to this day, I've never been drunk since I stopped hanging out with them guys. I've been a little tipsy, as you guys saw in that one stream, but that was just like the tip of the iceberg compared to what I used to be all the time. And I'm glad I don't. A, you save a ton of money, because alcohol is expensive. When you drink alcohol in excess, like I did it the early years, It gets expensive, especially when you're working at Walmart and you don't make that much money. Now, luckily, I found another job and I was making pretty good money, and most of it went to alcohol. But, you know, it is what it is. Should you ever not try alcohol? No, because alcohol is illegal, or alcohol is legal. And it's kind of a rite of passage, you know, to turn 21, go buy a drink. Congratulations, dude, you're an adult. Should you ever drink to excess and, you know, live to drink your, you know, drink your problems away? No. Just drink to have a good time. Drink responsibly. If you drink, don't drive, do the watermelon crawl. But yeah, that's all you... Don't drink because you feel like you have to. Don't drink because, you know, like your friends are telling you to do it. Because that's a bad reason to drink. If you do decide to try alcohol, do it, like I said. Do it as a rite of passage. You turn 21. You can go buy a drink now. Go out to wherever, a bar or what have you. I've never been to a bar myself, okay? Actually, I've never been out and ordered a drink. I've always drunk either at parties or, you know, like, I've never gone to a restaurant and ordered a drink, so on and so forth. So, you know, go wherever you do it right. Go out somewhere on your 21st birthday, order yourself a drink, and celebrate you becoming an adult. So that's going to do it. Sorry for the rambling. I wanted to make the video a little bit longer. A little bit more of a let's play instead of just a me rambling on and just cutting the video whenever I got done rambling. I really wanted to do, I totally missed all that, didn't I? Anyway, I wanted to do more of a let's play, show you guys what I'm actually doing. So I'm probably going to wrap up this field for the next, and it's missing that too. Wow. I don't know what's going on there. I think I was playing outside the map, so it's not going to cultivate under. But if you guys liked the video, be sure to leave a like down below. If you guys want to see more Let's Plays, Let's Talk, be sure to click subscribe. And as always, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.